Hello everyone, I am Professor Bhavik Kumar M. Kataria welcomes you to the video series of Computer Networks, and we are discussing unit number 1, Introduction. So till today, we have completed 3 sessions of Computer Network. First one was Understanding of Network and Internet. On that session, we have discussed about what is Internet, what is Network, what is Computer. And then after we have started the Network Edge and Network Core, we have also discussed the protocol, key elements of protocols like syntax, semantics, timing. Then after we have discussed mode of communications like half duplex and full duplex. In terms of Network Edge and Core, we have understood about the what is edge and what is core, as well as we have discussed the end systems, some of the devices like router, bridge, hub, types of networks like cable internet, access to the home, digital subscriber link, fiber optic network up to the home. And then after we have categorized this network into the categories of LAN, MAN and WAN. So LAN was for the simple company or a single organization. LAN was for the entire city, and WAN was for the more than one city, or it should be covering the entire earth. Then after we have discussed switching techniques. In terms of switching techniques, we have discussed circuit switching, message switching, packet switching, as well as we have discussed transmission media in terms of network and edge and core. So there is 2 types of media, wired media and wireless media. So in terms of wired media, it is known as a guided media, and wireless network is known as a unguided media. So there are coaxial cable, twisted pair cable, fiber optics. These are the examples of guided media, whereas in terms of unguided media, we have discussed infrared, Bluetooth, and some of the wireless techniques like radio waves, microwaves, etc. Then after we have discussed types of antenna, disk antenna, horn antenna, as well as we have discussed propagation mode like ground propagation, sky propagation, line of sight propagation. So these topics were according to the network edge and network core. So some of the things located at boundary of network that was known as a network edge, and some of the devices and cabling or some equipments located at a central part of a network. So at that time we have identified those part as a network core. Today we are going to discuss understanding of delay. Before starting the understanding of delay, I would like to say that we will discuss delay as well as loss and throughput also in terms of packet switch network. We have discussed circuit switch, message switch and packet switch. But packet switching is a very popular technique and currently used into the market. So we will discuss delay, loss and throughput according to the packet switch network. So let's see, that was the computer network and internet we have already discussed in our earlier sessions. So in that case, we will start with the packet switching, and we will discuss delay, loss and throughput. So first, let's start with the delay. So delay of a network specifies how much time data takes to travel across the path from source to destination. For example, in our previous sessions, like there are multiple devices are connected into the network. And we have discussed that is our end system, as well as one server here that is end system. Like this client is sending the data towards the server. So this client is known as a sender and server will known as a receiver. So whenever data will take a time to travel from source to destination, so this thing is known as a delay. Get it? It can measure in fraction of seconds. Suppose if you will look about the non-technical examples, like you are traveling from Ahmedabad to Mumbai. So you will take some particular amount of time to travel from one city to another city. Same thing, whenever data is going to travel from one place to another place, So it will take some amount of time, and this time is known as a delay. There are four types of delay: transmission delay, propagation delay, queuing delay, and processing delay. So we will discuss one by one all particular types here. So if you will look into the figure, so these are the two devices, desktop systems are there, and they are sending data towards the router. So here two routers are there, router A and router B. So we are going to measure the delay from the path of router A to router B. So let according to the figure, keep your concentration is here. We are going to measure the delay in between these two points, in between point A and point B. So right now, first we will look about the point A. So point A, this router is getting data from these two devices. It means after receiving, router A will transmit the data. So transmission delay, if you look about the transmission delay, transmission delay is look like whenever anyone person is transmitting the data. So how much time required to put data inside the channel? Because always channel is carrying data. Look like you are sending a parcel to someone. So whenever you will prepare a parcel and you will submitted it to the post office or any type of courier office, so they will bring your parcels and collect all number of parcels, and whenever they will send onto the any type of vehicles, like they are sending on train or they are sending the parcels on trucks, so whenever they are loading this type of parcels in any vehicle, so this procedure is known as a loading. Same thing in terms of data, this thing is known as a transmission. Whenever any sender is putting data inside the channel from their resources, so this thing is known as a transmission. It means sender is putting his or her particular data inside the channel. This delay is known as a transmission delay. Another thing, that is a propagation delay. Propagation delay is look like it is actual time to travel between one point to another point. Suppose data packets will start traveling from this router A and reach up to this router B. So whatever the time taken by these data packets to reach up to the B from point A, this time is measured as a propagation delay. Another thing is a queuing delay. Queuing delay is look like whenever channel is busy and your data packets are inside the queue and waiting for the pre-channel. So this amount of time is look like a queuing delay. Like whenever we are traveling with our own vehicle. So whenever we are reaching a toll booth. So if there is a traffic at toll booth, we are waiting to pay the toll inside the queue. So we are wasting some amount of time at that particular point. Same thing whenever channel is busy. So data packets are staying inside the queue for few amount of time. Actually, there is a very less amount of time if you will compare it with the total travel time. But that time is how to keep in mind. That thing is known as a queuing delay. Then after, another one is a processing delay. Look like in terms of packet switching, we have discussed data is travel inside into the various partition of packets. We are not sending entire message in a single unit. We are dividing our message into the number of data packets, and we are sending this individual data packets inside the channel. So whenever receiver will receive the data, so maybe receiver can receive the data packets into the out of order also. So suppose there is a five number of packets P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. We are sending in into the sequence, and receiver is receiving in out of order. Like receiver is receiving P3 first, then after P2, then after P4, then after P1, then after next packet. So there is need to rearrange this number of packets. Then and then receiver can extract the original message. If we are going to read the message by out of order packets, so we will get some another message or a wrong message. It means we are not getting actual interpretation of sender side. So there is need to rearrange the data packet. So this type of processing requires some amount of time, and this time is known as a processing delay. So whenever we will measure a total time, so we have to keep in mind these four parameters. One is for the transmission, second one is for propagation, third one is for queuing, and fourth one is processing. Whenever we will combine or we will make a summation of these four time, so we will get total travel time, or total time taken by the data packets to reach from sender to receiver. And this thing is known as a total nodal delay. So let's see one by one. First, transmission delay. So how we will measure the delay of transmission? So we will measure transmission delay is equal to L by B. Here L is equal to length of data packets and B is equal to bandwidth of data. Look like whenever you are using the internet. So you have listened the words like speed of 1 Mbps or speed of 10 Mbps. So actually it is a bandwidth, it's not a speed. Generally we are calling it speed, but in terms of communication it is called a bandwidth of data. Get it? So that is equation is L by B. Now let's calculate with the one example. Here into the example one, we are taking size of packet, length is equal to 10,000 bits. So data packets is 10,000 bits long, and bandwidth of channel is equal to 10 kbps. So first we will put a equation L by B. L is equal to 10,000 divided by B. B is a 10 kbps, so it is kilobit per second, but we will convert it into the bit per second. So we will multiply it with the 10^3, it means kilo. So we will get 10,000 upon 10,000. So our answer will be 1. Here in upper side there is a unit bits, and here there is a bit per second. So we will remove the bits and bits, so we will get unit as a second. Maybe somewhere answer should be asked into the millisecond or a microsecond. So after calculating your answer into the unit second, so you have to calculate it, or you have to convert it into the milliseconds or microseconds, depends on example given to you or answer asked to you. So that you have to keep in mind whenever you are going to calculate in numericals. So do not forget to write unit after the answers. Let's see another type, that is propagation delay. So in terms of propagation delay, equation is D by V. Here D is equal to distance and V is equal to velocity. Velocity is measured, it is velocity is considered of the transmission media. Get it? So somewhere you are using optical fiber. So in most of the cases velocity is 2.1 × 10^8 through the optical fiber. But in most of the cases it is in between, from 2 × 10^8 to 3 × 10^8, whatever it should be, like coaxial cable or a twisted pair cable. So there is a variations into the velocity of transmission media. So whenever you will change transmission media, so your velocity is going to be changed. But whenever question should be asked to you, so velocity is given to you. If velocity is not given by the examiner, so you have to take the velocity of optical fiber. Let's see example one. Distance is equal to 2.5 km. Get it? And velocity is equal to 2.5 × 10^8 kbps. So whenever you will calculate, so put the equations, that is a D by V, that is a print mistake, not a L by R, that is D by V. Here there is a 2.5 km, not a bits. So make one correction here. You have to put equation D by V. Distance is equal to 2.5 km. Whenever we will convert kilometer into the meter, so we will multiply it with the 10^3, because 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter, and velocity is 2.5 × 10^8. So we will remove the 2.5 and 2.5, so we will get 10^3 upon 10^8. So we will get answer 10^-5 second. same like we have discussed in earlier examples, you can convert it into the milliseconds or microseconds, or if there is no more mentions into the given data, so you can keep it into the second also. Two more types of delays are queuing delay and propagation delay. So we have measured two delays, transmission delay and propagation delay, by taking examples. But if you will look about the queuing delay and processing delay, so there is a very less amount of time as compared to transmission and propagation. So these delays are negligible. We are not calculating this time into the consideration, like we are traveling from Ahmedabad to Mumbai. So we are not calculating the waiting time of toll booth or whenever we are waiting at any traffic. So we are just calculating the journey time. So remaining time is negligible. Same thing in terms of data communications. We are considering transmission delay and propagation delay whenever we are calculating total node delay. We are not calculating queuing and processing because it is a very less amount of time. But whenever we are measuring the total nodal delay, so we are taking propagation delay two times. Why we are taking propagation delay two times? So if we will look here, whenever we are sending the data, so after sending the data, we are getting the acknowledgement in terms of stop and wait protocol. Where if we will compare the total nodal delay with the stop and wait protocol, so when we will start the next transmission, we will start the next transmission after receiving the earlier message acknowledgement. Like we are chatting with someone, so we are sending a message to someone. So whenever we are sending a next message, we are sending a next message after receiving the reply of first message. Get it? So then and then communication can take place. So that's why we are taking a delay of propagation two times. It means travel time of sending to receiver side and again back from receiver to sending side. It means we are taking a total cycle from like if we are considering Ahmedabad to Bombay. So Ahmedabad to Bombay and again return journey of Bombay to Ahmedabad. So that is an entire cycle. So hope you are understanding about the total delay. Let's see one question of reasoning. If you are in your final year of graduations, so whenever you will go for the your placement procedure, so you have to prepare reasonings and aptitudes. So it is an example of reasoning. Suppose this type of series is given to you, so how you have to calculate? So there is a variation in 3 plus 6 plus 9 up to t plus 3 and up to it is going up to the 90. So if we are going to calculate it manually, so it will take a too long time. But here I am suggesting you one equations, like it is fd plus ld into td divided by 2. Fd is equal to first digit, ld is equal to last digit, and td is equal to total difference. First digit is equal to 3, last digit is equal to 90, and total digits are 30. How we will get total digits? We will get total digits is equal to last digit upon difference. Last digit is equal to 90. Difference is 3. So 90 divided by 3. So we will get total number of digits here are 30. It means in this entire series there are total 30 number of digits. So if we will calculate it, so we will get 93 multiplied by 15 and we will get answer 1395. So we can calculate this type of fastest calculation by using the reasoning and aptitude techniques. If you have any question about the today's session, you can ask your questions or queries to me by commenting in comment box. Let's keep continue. We are going to discuss new topics. That topic is lossing packet switch network. So there are three types of losses: lossing data, lossing ACK, and delayed of ACK. First, we will discuss loss in data. So if we will look about the loss in data, so whenever we are sending the sender is sending the data towards the receiver. Suppose this data packet is corrupted in between the channel, or receiver is not able to receive the data. So receiver will not send acknowledgement towards the sender. So how sender will able to know that data is received or not? Sender will able to know that when sender will receive an acknowledgement, then sender can know about that like my data is already reached at receivers less. But suppose sender is not receiving the acknowledgement. So how sender will decide my data is already received at receiver's place or not? So sender will wait for some amount of time. Suppose there is a timer of 5 milliseconds. So sender will send up to the 5 milliseconds. If within a 5 milliseconds sender is not receiving the acknowledgement, so sender will send their message again towards the receiver when timer will complete. So that is one solution of loss data, that is timeout timer. But suppose there is a loss of acknowledgement whenever sender is sending the data, and the receiver already received the data and receiver forwarded the acknowledgement signal towards the sender, but somewhere acknowledgement signal is corrupted and sender will not be able to receive the acknowledgement. So sender will think that my data is not actually sent towards the receiver. So after completion of timeout timer, sender will send data packets again. But actually there is not a loss of data. There was a loss of acknowledgement. So sender will send a second packet and receiver will receive that packet again. So receiver have two packets. So second packet is a duplicate packet. So that is a problem during the loss of acknowledgement signal. So again, there is need to implement some policy. So what we are doing here, with the timeout timer, we are mentioning sequence number for the data. Like whenever we are sending number of data packets, so we will use a number like data packet 1, data packet 2, data packet 3. Get it? So whenever receiver will receive the data packet 1, and again receiver will receive data packet 1, so receiver will able to know that this packet is duplicate packet, and out of these two packets receiver will remove one packet and keep one packet on their record. So this problem is going to be solved out. Another thing, delay of acknowledgement or mixing of acknowledgement. Whenever acknowledgement is delayed, so there is a chance to mixing of ACK. Like sender have sent data packet 1 and receiver sent the acknowledgement 1. Same thing, if this acknowledgement is not received, then sender will send another data packet. So after receiving another data packet, receiver will again send the acknowledgement. And whenever sender will receive two acknowledgement, whatever the acknowledgement was delayed, look like somewhere we are traveling by bus from one station to another station. So there is somewhere possibility look like earlier bus is coming late and next bus arriving first. Because in earlier cases, like some of the vehicles are captured into the traffic. So maybe there is a possibilities of out of order receiving that we have already discussed into the packet switch network. Somewhere due to the line is busy, so packet is are receiving in out of order. So whenever receiver will send multiple ACKs towards the sender, so sender will not be able to determine which ACK is that. That ACK is for data packet 1 or ACK is for data packet 2. So whenever sender is receiving multiple ACKs, so there is a mixture of ACK. So again, there is need to assign a sequence number to acknowledgement. Same look like data packets. Whenever we have assigned the numbers to data packets, like data packets 1, 2 and 3, same sequence number we can allocate to the acknowledgement signal also, like acknowledgement signal 1, acknowledgement signal 2, acknowledgement signal 3 and so on. So these are the loss in packet switch network. Next, we will discuss throughput. So what is throughput? It is the actual performance. Like here, it is our point number 1 and that is point number 2. Router of sender and router of client. So router of server and router of client. So whenever server is sending a data towards the client, so suppose there is a single client, so that client will able to use entire channel. But suppose in second case there are total 10 number of clients and 10 number of servers. So whenever 10 people are communicating with each other, so if there is a same channel of capacity, so it will generate the traffic or a collision, but there is need to increase the channel capacity. Like due to the heavy traffic, government is implementing the 4-lane roads or 6-lane roads or 8-lane roads. Day by day, we are increasing the width of roads or number of lanes. Same thing in terms of data communications. Whenever there is a multiple persons are communicating with one another, so there is need to increase the capacity of channel. So whatever the capacity of channel is there, out of those capacity, whatever the capacity we are able to use, this thing is known as a throughput. Like there is a 4-lane road, and out of this 4-lane road, in one lane there is some accident or due to any reason one lane is blocked. So currently we are using 3 lanes only. So that is a throughput. Out of 4 lanes, if we are able to use 3 lanes only, so this thing is known as a throughput. Same thing in terms of data communication for a computer network. Whatever the channel capacity is there, out of those particular channel capacity, whatever the capacity we are able to use, this thing is known as a throughput in network. Let's see efficiency of stop and wait protocol. So how we will calculate the efficiency? Like sender is transmitting the data, so we will calculate it useful time upon total cycle time. So let's see, whenever we are transmitting the data, so we are waiting for the acknowledgement in terms of stop and wait protocol. Whenever we will receive acknowledgement, then and then sender will send another packet. So what is the actual useful time? Actual useful time is delay of transmission, because whatever the time sender is taking to transmit the data, that is actual useful time. Remaining time sender is waiting for the ACK. So at that time sender is not sending any type of data. It means sender is idle. So this thing is not a useful time, because sender is waiting for acknowledgement. So what is this time? One time for delay of propagation from sending to receiver, and another propagation time from sender to, sorry, receiver to sender. So there is a two-way journey. So we will calculate 2 into delay of propagation time. So 2 into delay propagation time, sender is idle. And the actual total time is transmission time plus 2 into delay of propagation. So we will consider useful time is equal to delay of transmission time, and total cycle time is equal to delay of transmission plus 2 into delay of propagation. So by solve out these equations, we will divide it into the delay of transmission. So we will get 1 into 1 plus 2 into delay of propagation divided by delay of transmission. Suppose in place of delay of propagation divided by delay of transmission, we are considering A. So we will get efficiency is equal to 1 upon 1 plus 2A. That is the efficiency of stop and wait protocol. Let's see next. There is a throughput. Throughput N is equal to L divided by delay of transmission plus 2 into delay of propagation. Why here we are considering L? L is equal to length of packet. It means size of packet. And this time is total total useful time, total time available. So if we will consider about the throughput in like non-technical examples like vehicle. So somewhere some of the lanes are blocked for the heavyweight vehicle. If there is there are a smaller lane, so we cannot run our heavy vehicle into the smaller lane. We can run with the bikes and cars, but there is a heavy truck, so there is a one another lane for the heavyweight vehicles. So same thing in terms of channel, we will consider length of packet divided by total available capacity. Get it? So by solving this equation, we will use multiplication, multiply and divided by B. So we will multiply L into B, and we will divide it by L divided by B. So by making these equations, we will get L by B. In place of L by B, we will put delay of transmission. So we will get transmission delay into bandwidth divided by delay of transmission plus 2 into delay of propagation. So for solving these equations, we will divide entire equations by delay of transmission. So here we will get 1 into B. In this sections, we will get 1 plus 2 into delay of propagation divided by delay of transmission. In place of delay of propagation divided by delay of transmission, suppose we will put delay of propagation into delay of transmission is equal to A. So we will get 1 into 1 plus 2A divided by B. So what was the 1 into 1 plus 2A? So if we will look, so there is a efficiency of stop and wait protocol. So what we will get in place of throughput? So we will get throughput is equal to efficiency into bandwidth. Get it? So whenever we will solve the numerical part, whenever somewhere throughput asked to you, so in place of equation of throughput, we will put efficiency into bandwidth, and in place of efficiency, we will put 1 into 1 divided by 1 plus 2a. So that is all about the throughput. Hope you are understanding very well. In our next session, we will discuss layered architecture. In terms of layered architecture, we will discuss two topics, OSI model and TCP/IP model. So stay connected. Thanks for watching.